Under the Create panel, there are two commands that can be used to create rib-like structures which are commonplace in plastic design. One is of course the rib command. The other is the web command. How do we decide between these two commands? Before we get into this discussion, let's quickly orientate ourselves about a typical rib feature. These are usually thin structures that straddle the main walls of a model. Let's take a look at the cross section. For the purposes of this discussion, we shall define this as the long side and this as the short side. The main difference between the rib and the web commands is where you define to be the sketch plane. For web, it is on a short side. For rib, it is on a long side. Let's take a look at this in action. For this box, let's try using the web command to create this feature. For the web command, the sketch line needs to be done on the short side. So we need to perform the sketch on this plane. We can start a sketch on the top surface of the box. Let's simply sketch a line in an arbitrary position. There's no need to extend the line to the edges. The web command takes care of that. Go to Create, Web. Select the sketch line as the curve. Adjust the thickness. With the depth option set to next and the extend curves option checked, the feature extends to the base and the side walls. To emphasize again, for the web command, the sketch is to be done on the short side. Let's see what happens if we try to use the rib command on this sketch. Go to Create, Rib. Select the sketch line as a curve. When we adjust the thickness, you can see that the feature has been created in a way that is perpendicular to the feature that was created by the web command. Flipping the direction does not help us in this case. In order to use the rib command to create the same feature, we will need to create an offset plane parallel to the side wall and create the sketch line on that plane. To emphasize again, for the rib command, the sketch has to be done on the long side. For more complex rib designs, where there are multiple ribs or even ribs at an angle, you can imagine that the rib command will be a very inefficient way, as that will mean having to create multiple sketch planes. If we use a web command, we can simply sketch multiple lines on the top face. For the next example, we need to create a feature like so. Let's use the rib command. We need to create the sketch on the long side. In this case, we can sketch on the front plane. Again, we do not need to extend the line to the opposite faces. Start the rib command and select the sketch. Adjust the thickness. We can replicate this feature using the web command. Remember that we will need to sketch on the short side in this case. In order to do that, we need to create a plane at an angle. You can see that it is relatively awkward to use the web command in this case. In conclusion, when deciding between the rib and web commands, it is important to think about how you want to approach the sketches.